simple differential equations. The relationship between the input and output of any linear time-variant measuring system, including sensor or transducer. This simple differential equation describes the dynamic performance. This is the measured input signal, x as a function of t, output signal, and a, b are constant. Now, input value, in order to assess the dynamic performance, could be of different form. Could be a step change. We can calculate for the step change. We are able to expose our sensor. This is time, this is amplitude, to the step change. So the rise time should be in the ideal situation should be zero, but in the real world, in some cases, nano or microseconds. Now, could be sinusoidal wave. We can also calculate the dynamic performance for sinusoidal wave. There are two usual input signals. So for step change, this equation is reduced to the more simple form, and we can solve this. We can solve this for several cases. The first one is so-called zero-order transducer. When all coefficients other than A0 are assumed zero, we can get very simple response. And the simplest example of such a sensor is displacement sensor, potentiometer. When we still use this simple sensor still used by industry. The movement of the slider with the displacement change, it gives us different voltage on the output, so the transfer characteristic will be voltage change versus displacement. So it's the simplest example. Simplest examples of zero order. First order transducer, when all these coefficients except for A1, A0 and A1 are assumed zero. So in this case, we can define time constant of our transducer as a ratio of these two constants. A1 to A0 is the time constant, and the ratio B0 to B1 is a static sensitivity, is a slope of the transfer characteristic. So in this case, we have a simple first ordinary differential equation. We can calculate the response. So solving this equation, we have a response of our transducer is like this, and as you know, when the output reaches 63% of the final reading, this is time constant. This is a graphical depiction of the first order transducer response with the time constant. So thermocouple is a good example of a first order transducer. We can calculate dynamic performance for a thermocouple using this differential equation. Now, how to compare how to design experiment for the thermocouple, how we can create step function for the thermocouple, step function temperature, simplest way in the laboratory, how we can do the step function or something similar to the step function, because step function, ideal step function is timerized zero. Simple approach. Who will help me? How to I calculated the response using the differential equation, and now I am trying to compare experimental results with theory. How to do this with for the thermocouple? How to generate step function in the experiment with the thermocouple? Very simple question. Alejandro, that's right? Sometimes, again, using common sense, nothing special, nothing difficult. I'm, again, sensor thinking. What can I do?
Put in a hot plate.
Say it again.
Put in a hot plate.
Hot plate dangerous because we can damage thermocouple, yeah? But safe approach is that I am keeping thermocouple at room temperature, 23 degrees centigrade. I have a glass cup with a boiling water, 100 degree, and I am immersing this thermocouple as soon as very fast in a boiling water. Yeah, so I will have from 23 to 100. Of course, it's not the ideal step function, but it's something similar. Okay. Now, next. Second order transducer situation is a little bit more complicated because all these coefficients except for A0, A1 and A2 are assumed zero. So again, we have simplified equation. This is a static sensitivity already defined. And now we have two parameters. The ratio of A1 to A2 is so-called undamped natural frequency. And damping ratio, epsilon, is defined in a such a way. So, after rearrangement, we are getting this equation, and we can do the graphically, we can get the response, dynamic response. So, let's look at this response. Which one is acceptable, which of them is accepting, which are not acceptable from dynamic performance point of view, which are not. Let's say the first one, this one, under damp, is acceptable or not? Who will help me? Wait, step by step. The first one, my question, this is acceptable or not? Why not? Why not? Why is not acceptable? Sensor thinking. The result that we are discussing this basic because I have to pass the sensor thinking to you, yeah, which is very unique thinking.
Maybe because it doesn't have stability.
Why? Why you are mixing? Don't listen. In sensor business, there is a tendency. I observed it many times with my students, undergraduate or PhD students, or around the world. That people have a tendency to mix different parameters. No. Leave the stability in peace. It has nothing to do with dynamic performance. Yeah? My question is, are we happy with this response? Look, this is time axis. What sort of sensor are we got with this time of response in the case of carbon monoxide sensor? Good sensor or not?
slow. This is low.
Loudly, please. Loudly again.
Slowly. Slowly.
Slow. Very slow. I have to wait long period of time to get the final reading. That's right. So it's useless. When I am this developing hydrogen sensor, I cannot wait 2 hours for the response because the result is useless. I need a fast response. That's right. Fast response. So this one is useless. Now, this one for different epsilon values. This one undone. Is acceptable or not? Huh? Rajesh, let's, I've memorized his name, so let's concentrate on Rajesh today. Rajesh, is acceptable or not?
Yes.
Why? If you are saying why,
because,
justify your reply. Why?
Periodically, it is like,
Is he right or wrong? What is your opinion?
He's right.
Pan?
He's right.
Don't follow others. Never follow others. Think independently.
Response is faster within 3 seconds.
Look, again.
It's one.
This is oscillating.
It's periodic.
Oscillating type of response. I'm happy with oscillating type of response?
No.
Common sense says no. I don't need any oscillating type of response because I will never reach
the desired output.
The
reading,
the proper reading. I will never reach, never. I can wait 5 years. No result. That's right. So this is useless. This is useless. Now, this one is slightly better than this. Am I happy with this type of response? Different type of epsilon. Different value of epsilon. I'm happy? The same story. No, I'm not happy. So this one, critically down. Not bad, yeah? Because I'm reaching final reading relatively quickly. So what is the conclusion? That I have to select, I have to optimize the damping ratio properly. That's right? Now, this is algebra. This is algebra. Let me tell you something from my experience. This stuff is from every textbook. Now, in chemical sensing domain, are we able to do the modeling job for dynamic performance or not? What is the best approach? You're already doing this. The best approach is experiment. Experiment, yeah? But let me generalize this issue. This is basic algebra. It works in some cases, but big companies in Silicon Valley, they have millions of dollars budget, hundreds of millions. They can design special software for newly developed sensors. They have money. We have no money and time to develop such a software, specialized software, for instance, for acceleration sensors. Why they can spend so much money? Because the market is huge. Market is huge, so that's a good investment. They can calculate the dynamic performance. They can optimize acceleration sensor design, accelerometer. And they can compare these theoretical results with experiment. It has a sense. In many cases, in sensor technology, the best, simplest engineering approach is experiment. Not only this, how can I generate step function for carbon monoxide concentration? Or how can I generate sine wave, generator with sine wave, carbon monoxide concentration? This is crazy idea. I don't know how to do it. It's impossible. Step function, maybe something, but this is a waste of time. The best approach, experiment, yeah? Multi-channel gas calibration system, introducing quickly carbon monoxide to the chamber, purging carbon monoxide, filling the gas chamber with the fresh air, and so on, so on. The same story in liquid media. I cannot generate sine wave of potassium ions or sine wave of hormones. Impossible. So experiment. Specialized software for sensors where the market is in the range of millions of pieces. This has a sense. Now, let's dream a little bit. Dreaming. High performance sensor. Let's go through these parameters. If we are in a dreaming mood, yeah, we are working in this field, we are dreaming about perfect sensor. What does it mean, perfect sensor? Any type of sensor. Of course, we need a high accuracy, small error, high resolution, as highest as possible, high sensitivity, perfect selectivity, low minimal detectable signal, low threshold. It will be nice if the calibration curve is fully linear. No hysteresis, excellent repeatability. I'm coming back to my lab on Monday and I'm getting the same result of the output signal regarding output signal than 2 months later. The same repeatability, perfect sensor. Yeah? Low noise, low instability and drift, high reproducibility, immunity to environmental parameters. Environmental parameters are not influencing my output at all. And excellent dynamic performance, low response, and
it should be high response.
I mean, low response time. Yeah, low response time, fast response, low response time, and fast recovery. It means low recovery time. If it's a 1 microsecond, I'm happy. If it's a 1 hour, I'm very unhappy. Yes, please.
Excuse me, professor. What's the difference between the response of a sensor and sensitivity?
Between
sensor response and sensitivity of the sensor. These parameters are very different, I think.
You are asking me a question. What is the difference between
sensor response and sensor
sensitivity? So this is the best evidence that you are not doing homework. That's right? I caught you. That's right? Because all these slides were distributed, yeah, yesterday. Distributed. Sensitivity is a static parameter. Static parameter. This is the slope of the calibration curve. That's right? But response time is a dynamic parameter. It's a completely different domains. That's right? So tonight you will read, you will study You will study handouts, that's right. Sometimes it's good in practice. You have to encourage people to study, that's right. Studying is good. It's good. Encouraging. Yeah? That's right. It's good for brain. Yeah? When I'm studying, my brain is not shrinking. Huh? No brain atrophy. If I'm not using my muscles, muscle atrophy. I'm becoming weak. The same story with brain. That's right. Working is good. It's good. Working is good. God created us to work.
I think he was not talking about response time, but only response.
No, he asked me a question, precise question. What is the difference between sensor sensitivity and sensor response?
So response, not response time.
Okay, response. Okay, so. Because I understood you that you are mixing static and dynamic. Okay, this is let's reply to this question because it's a very important question. Let me tell you something. Some people are using term sensitivity. Gas sensor people know very well that other people are also using term responsivity. Sensitivity and responsivity is the same. Responsivity is also static parameter. But response is a dynamic parameter because immediately the bells are ringing in my brain. Response, I consider response time, dynamic performance. But responsivity, static, the same like sensitivity. So if you ask me a question, what is the difference between sensitivity and responsivity, I will reply, there is no difference. Yeah? In one of your papers, I believe I read this, there is a responsivity of the sensor. That's right? Responsivity of the sensor. So, can we get this, all this, can we fulfill this dream? Of course not. Impossible. Trade-off. I already mentioned. Trade-off between different parameters. Trade-off. Getting high sensitivity, accuracy of my sensor is not very good. Yeah? One parameter is missed in this list. Which parameter is missed? Very important parameter. I did it on the purpose. Which parameter in modern world is very important? Which parameter is very important? It's not listed here. Very important parameter for the sensor.
Resolution?
Rajesh? Rajesh is very keen to help. Which parameter is missed? It was not discussed at all. But very important in modern world. Cost. Perfect. Cost. Everybody knows that I can design wonderful sensor trying to minimize trade-off, but the cost will be very high. Any question, gentlemen? These two talking gentlemen in the last. Any question? No? Ask me question. I like questions. Okay, so cost. I can design very expensive sensor, spending a lot of time, and price on the market will be high, with very good parameters, but nobody will buy it. This is the result, yeah?
The size?
Size?
Small size.
Yeah, size, dimensions are very important. Very important, yeah, because they are affecting the dynamic performance. And we discussed that sometimes miniaturization is good, sometimes is not justified. Not always justified. So in the real world, always trade off between different parameters. And we always have to consider the real world situation, because sometimes we don't need high accuracy in an industrial environment. Sometimes we don't need. So it's no need to fight for the high accuracy. Sometimes sensitivity is not the most important parameter. Sometimes dynamic parameters, the sensor could be relatively slower with a relatively slow response and recovery because it satisfies us. So every time we have to consider the real world situation in which the sensor will operate. Because again and again, laboratory environment is different from the world, real world environment, real weight environment. So we have to have a holistic approach, like we discussed on the corridor with Rajesh. We have to have holistic approach to our body. We have to have a holistic approach to any type of sensor, having in mind all these parameters. If we are getting one of them is excellent parameter, others will suffer. Others could suffer enormously. There is no perfect sensor. Any questions at this stage? Please.
An observation that's related to the cost.
Cost, related to the cost of the sensor, yeah?
And here in Mexico, for the past, 20 years, the problem to to the money for research is a problem. Then
with great respect, not only in Mexico,
many countries
around the world, the same situation.
Yes, but this is a little different because here in Sinestra, we have been working in not well conditions. And then some kind of work, research work, was directed to achieve research products using the idea of low cost.
Which is very correct approach.
Okay, but in this case there is a problem because to reach a product, a wet product, there is a limit. The money is necessary to buy some chemicals, to buy some, GDM altimeters, the least parts to do research.
I tell you, we need
to make a precision related to the cost and not to confuse this concept with the cost of the products produced by research activities.
I fully understand your point, but let me reply in a very personal manner. Very personal manner. It will be at the first stage I will reply to your question in a very personal, simplified manner. When I am in the real world, I have always two solutions. Every sort of situation in life, every sort of life situation, not only in a research activity. The first option is that I am in such a situation that first option is to be frustrated, feeling uncomfortable, and suffering. suffering, because this is a suffering, yeah? I have a brilliant idea, but I cannot implement this idea because I have a limited budget, I have no such a sophisticated equipment, and I have no money to buy certain sort of expensive chemicals. Mm-hmm. This is first approach, but this approach, in my opinion, is killing you. Mm-hmm. It's killing you, because being frustrated is not good for our health.
Yes.
It's not good.
Yes,
it's not a good idea to spend, you know, a couple of months in a hospital. It's better to enjoy life, to drink good tequila, yeah, to listen mariachi, to be joyful. This is the first option. This is the one end of the spectrum. Second end, I tell you something, this is very personal consideration. I already told Dr. Alejandro when I went first time to the US as a student, yeah? As a student. It was cultural shock. I worked in a factory to earn money. I worked overnight in Chicago in a metal factory to earn money to buy Greyhound tickets. Mm-hmm. I was traveling all night because no money for hotels. I was sleeping in a Greyhound. Yeah? Yeah? And I was traveling around the US. But I look at this, I'm European by origin. So I said, this culture is not accepted for me. I'm not interested in this mass culture, yeah? I'm not interested in Hollywood movies. I'm not interested in McDonald's or Kentucky Fried Chicken. It's not for me. I was not happy. But I tell you something, step by step I discovered that American culture offers a lot. But let me tell you one story, very specific story. I attended Transducer Congress, and during this time I worked in Canada, and Transducer Congress took place in Philadelphia. So I went with a Canadian professor by car because I submitted a paper, and in an underground passage I met the American guy. He lost a job mm-hmm. 1 year before, and he was telling me, I have no money, I am sleeping on the floor, on the ground, yeah. Every evening he was taking his trousers, yeah, and putting under the plastic, so they were looking as they were iron, they were not, and he says, every day, what happened when he lost his job? It is America, because he was useless for his wife, he was not bringing money home, so she kicked him out from his home. Yeah, he was sleeping on the floor. But he says, I am looking for a job every day. And I know for sure that one day I will find a job. He was positive. So what I learned from American culture, to be always positive. Never be frustrated. Never be negative. Never feel uncomfortable. Now, coming back to the point. Look. If I have no money, if I have no wonderful equipment, I can still achieve a lot.
Yes.
A lot. Being positive. This is the first mm-hmm. point. I have to be positive. You know very well that regarding, let's concentrate on nanotechnology. From one side of the spectrum, we have a very sophisticated deposition technique. Langmuir-Blodgett technique, yeah? I can obtain defect-free layer, well-oriented, molecularly well-oriented, perfect layers. But equipment, at least $1 million.
Mm-hmm.
$1 million. Other side of the spectrum, I can use simple techniques, for instance, salt gel, yeah? Very cheap, very inexpensive, I can get wonderful results. You know, at the one stage in my lab, one of my PhD students, we developed, as the first in the world, binary compounds, using salt gel approach, using little money, lot of fun, lot of joy. We published several papers, they are very well cited. Binary compounds, like a molybdenum trioxide, tungsten trioxide, molybdenum trioxide, titanium dioxide. Very nice results, very good results.
Yes,
so this is the second end of the spectrum. Your approach is absolutely correct. Chemical synthesis. Chemical synthesis. I look at the Rajesh zinc oxide morphology. Beautiful morphology. Great potential. Also for sensing applications. Also for sensing applications. Why? Because you are positive. You are trying to do as much as possible using your resources and using your budget. That's right? Always be positive. I am not interested. Sometimes, look, all of us around the world, irrelevant which country we are living, we have a similar brain. My Polish brain is not worse than American brain. Or your Mexican brain is not worse than American brain. You have your intellectual power could be very high. You can develop wonderful idea, and you are thinking, how can I implement this idea using my limited resources? The reason why I delivered this example with QCM, because the transducer costs $2. $2. And I can design a sensor with limited amount of money, and my paper could be cited 200 times if that's a brilliant idea. That's
okay.
Right?
I agree in all with you. But maybe you not missing the point is that here in Mexico we have been working with very cheap things for a long time. But the point I try to point out is that we not change our mind in order to use those resources. We are working on only following, as you pointed, the good results that are writing the journals and I don't know, but we need to change a little.
So
in order to make useful things with those products as a machines, and we have some examples. In order to assure that we are working as you said.
But sorry.
But we need
for
to make more intensive work.
For better understanding. You are saying that with certain sort of mentality, mm-hmm. certain sort of approach, you are saying that you are not creating. Mm-hmm. That's what you are saying, that you are following.
Yes.
You are following well established paths.
Yes.
With great respect, I disagree with you. Because when I studied the Rishikesh paper yesterday evening, Rajesh, sorry, look again, jet lag, Rajesh. Much easier to, Krishna I repeated hundreds of times, so I memorized very well. Rajesh, you have very good quality papers, very good quality papers.
Yes, I agree.
As I said, morphology is beautiful. There is a great application potential for this material. Mm-hmm. Not big money are involved. It's a very good quality job. Very good quality job. Yeah? Similar story, there is a novelty also in tin dioxide nanoplatelets of Krishna. This is a very good job in nanotechnology. There's nothing wrong with having such a approach. We can modify this if you are, look, when I'm positive, the next point, this is very important, next point, I'm staying in my lab, yeah? We are working on graphene. And graphene-related composites, because this is hot subject, it offers enormous opportunities in the future. Yeah? In my laboratory, we have no chemical vapor deposition equipment. I cannot obtain a real graphene, monoatomic layer. So, I can obtain the graphene oxide, which is not a pure drug. Again, I have two options. I will publish several papers, they are well cited, but based on a graphene oxide, not a graphene. But I have some ideas. Again, I have two options. One option is to sit down and to whinge, being frustrated. I have no chemical vapor deposition, I cannot do this. I'm frustrated, you know, I'm not sleeping well. Medical doctors are waiting for me to make good money. Yeah? One option, one attitude. Second option is, I have a good idea. I am attending international congress. I am approaching people who are working in a rich laboratory. My last paper from Barcelona, transducer, which I sent to you, I approach American team in Kansas. They have a CBD. They were happy to follow with my idea. And we collaborated together. We got very nice results. Okay. We published in a prestigious conference. So second attitude is very positive. My brain is not worse than their brains, yeah? I don't care where I am. Shall I be frustrated because I'm working in a laboratory which has no CBD technique? No. Now I will jump to Stanford to attend conference. I will talk to several people. Later I will be at UCLA. UCLA, they had CBD. Okay. I'm collaborating with them. I publish at least 20 papers with Professor Kanner team. I'm looking for the look. There is a famous biologist experiment. I'm counting on your sense of humor now. I'm trying to contaminate you in a positive way with a positive way of thinking, which is, in my opinion, a very important part of American culture. That's what I learned in the US. There is a famous biologist experiment. They created artificial labyrinth, and they put two sort of rats. First gate, yeah? One rat was very slim, yeah? Probably he was not eating meat. probably he was vegetarian. The guy was looking for the exit. This way, not correct. This way, doesn't work. This one, doesn't work. This one, doesn't work, yeah? Being very persistent, finally he found the exit, being very happy, yeah? They put the second rat, he was pretty fat, yeah, pretty fat. The second rat tried one option, second option, he says, no, this is too difficult, I have to rest. I'm not going to waste my time to look for the exit. He was frustrated. The reason this is very rough stuff, but when you are positive, look, in a sense of technology, international collaboration is crucial for the success. Because I mentioned at the beginning, none of us sitting in this room, and nobody in the world, is a Renaissance man like Leonardo da Vinci. 16th century, excellent sculptor, painter, engineer, you know. We have limited knowledge. As I said, my background in physical chemistry is very limited. I learned to communicate with physical chemists, but if I'm going to be successful, I have to collaborate with physical chemists. That's the reason why people setting up multidisciplinary team in the sense of technology. The solution to your problem, I believe that the major solution to your problem is to have an international collaboration. and to be present on international arena. I advise Dr. Olvera, there's a wonderful conference in South America, in Buenos Aires, March 2014. Chemical sensor conference, all experts from all over the world will come. I can interact with them, I can learn a lot, I can have a discussions, I can generate new ideas, and I can establish collaboration with them. Yeah. Why should be frustrated?
I am not frustrated.
Of course you are.
I am trying to make
mentality limits. Mentality limits, there is no mentality.
No. For example, it's very good that you are talking with us. Because you have
my wife after this will criticize me. I'm sure that she will criticize me. She will say few things against me. But I am who I am, you know, I'm genuine, I'm yes. Real. Yes. It's not a
you are a special researcher.
I'm special?
Just that.
In a positive or negative? In a positive. Thank you.
The concept, the words, the terms that you are exposing to us said that the things can be with.
Everything.
Can I
interrupt you for a second? Follow you for a second. Sorry. I tell you something. My personal philosophy is you can achieve everything in life if you want. Mm-hmm. Everything. If you set up the goal, you can achieve everything. Of course, sometimes price is very high. Sometimes price is very high. But you can achieve everything. This is American attitude, which I really appreciate. They are always positive. The guy is losing his job, yeah? He has in his pocket he has a hole, even one greenback. He has no even one greenback. But he's positive. He says, I know that I will find a job. And one day he will be successful. The same story, this is the matter of approach, I believe. This is to some extent, and I believe that this approach is right, because I proved myself that in my personal case, it works. It works. It works. To be always positive, to look always for the exit, to look always for the solution, and don't let myself to be frustrated, don't let myself to think about negatives. If this route is not good, maybe this is good. If not good, the next one. One day I will find out the nice solution. This is my approach. Sorry, Dean. Exposing this personal views, but this is my approach. I'm not saying that this approach will be good for you or for you, because you have different experience, life experience, you have a different way of thinking maybe, but it works in my case. It works in my case. And I try to contaminate you with the optimism.
Yes. It's very good for us.
I agree.
Yes, I
agree. With the optimism. Dr. Olvera is laughing. She will not tell me what she thinks about this, that's right.
No, I agree with you.
Yes. You are very
totally.
Kind. Very kind. Very kind. Very kind. Yeah? Very kind. But this is the only way. You can achieve a lot in nanotechnology, having little money. Having no sophisticated equipment, you can achieve a lot. You can produce highly cited papers, which is our this sort of university, your institution is a very crucial factor. Yeah, because bosses and government, what they are looking for? They are looking for the number of completed PhD thesis, they are looking for a number of papers,
yes.
Number of citations, they are looking for this. They are not interested in I understand, I think, very well. Because I discussed this is my third visit in Mexico. Mm-hmm. There is a term, colloquial language, industrial sucking. When you have a strong industry in the country, industry is very much interested in your work. That's right? Mm-hmm. They are interested in your results. If you have no industry, you are in a, working in a, some sort of ivory tower. You are producing PhD student papers and so on and so on. But if you believe, look, commercialization culture, this is the mother of commercialization culture. Definitely commercialization culture exists in United States, mm-hmm. in Germany,
in China now, in Japan,
in Korea, does not exist in many European countries. Does not exist. Mm-hmm. Does not exist. Maybe there is a strong commercialization culture in Canada compared to the US. I don't think so. No. So if there is no commercialization culture, what can I do? Like this. Shall I think about government, why he is not supporting industry, local industry, microelectronic industry, or it does not support strongly research? Why should I think about this? I don't care. I'm doing my job, enjoying my life. Let's see. I'm positive, optimistic.
Maybe to... clarification to make more clear my intervention, because this is very important. In the past years, here in Mexico, a lot of researchers use the word cost in order to use as an argument to do things, only to do things. Then, my point is that this term not must be introduced in the stage of making a research, making a PhD thesis, making a master in science thesis. The term cost.
Okay.
This is the point.
Again, I understand your point. But let me tell you something. This term cost is used widely everywhere around the world. Mm-hmm. Everywhere around the world.
Yes, I
not only that. Not only in Mexico, also in the US, also in Japan, everywhere. Of course, during all days of my professional career, I was very lucky because I was doing what I wanted to do. I have a freedom of selecting the right topic, which was right for me. I was not, harassed by the government or Ministry of Higher Education. Yeah. Nowadays, there are limitations. Unfortunately, everywhere around the world, the term cost is used. Everywhere. In every country around the world, unfortunately. And we are not able to change it. Sorry.
Yes. Mm-hmm.
We are not able to change it, and that's it. There's no reason to be frustrated because of it. You should, don't care. Do your job, enjoy your life, deliver as much as possible, publish, be passionate, yeah? Passion. This job is about passion. Yeah, many times we are curiosity driven, we are doing something because we are curious, we are trying to achieve some results. This is, I tell you something, what I am telling my PhD students, when they are coming to my lab, I am telling them simple things. First of all, I am telling them, this is the best years of your professional career. They are asking me why. I said, simply because you are working for yourself. You are working for your future. That's right. You are working for yourself. Later, a year later, you will work for the certain institution, corporate organization, all this. So you have some bosses above you. Some of them with great respect are idiots. But you have to listen to them, yeah, what they are saying. But now you are working for yourself. This is the first point. Second point I am telling them. We are riding one horse. One horse. I am riding with you one horse. We are going in one direction. Your failure is my failure. Your success is my success. You should understand this. And I'm telling them further on. You have to be driven by passion. You have to be, when you are working in scientific research, you have to be a little bit crazy, in a positive way. A little bit crazy, you know? You have to be a loco, a little bit. That's right? This is not a post office work. Post office work does not need any passion. Yeah? You have to be driven by passion. And you have to enjoy your work. In this case, you always will be successful. If you are positive, you always will be successful, sooner or later. And don't let you to be frustrated. Don't let you to start to whinge. Don't let you to feel uncomfortable, because it affects your health. Yeah? I tell you something. That's I believe that's the right approach. You are doing a wonderful job. There's no, this is the, I would like to say that this is world-class job obtained with limited resources. It is not the matter of having millions and millions of dollars to get good results. Mm-hmm. It's easy, yeah? But having limited resources, having limited equipment in the laboratory and getting good results, this is the art.
Yes, yes.
This is the art.
A positive result.
This is
in the life.
This is really you should be proud of this. You're not worse than others. No? You're doing a very good job.
Yes, yes, yes. I am sure that I completely sure.
Look, today we had a discussion with Dr. Olvera. Look, today I'm sending email to Melbourne. They will send special transducers and we will move forward together. We will get very nice results together, yeah? Hopefully we'll publish jointly. Everybody will be happy. And I will show you several techniques. We can collaborate.
Okay.
And look, this is the win-win situation. It's good for me, it's good for you. Why it's good for me? Because I can come back to Mexico. It's very important for me.
That the assistants don't the tennis is named idea. The point is the cost is what the word that do all this cost, the term cost. But there is another is not similar the word that is some similar to cheap. Cheap, the low cost. The usual term is cost. Cost is high cost, low cost. But there is another term in English. Cheap. 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 In Spanish is barato. Mm-hmm. This is a word that was originated in Arabia. The most barato. Barato, barato is related to bad quality.
Not
here,
really.
Here in Mexico.
Not really. Because let me tell you something. A few times during these 3 days, I said that the simple approach, many times is the best approach. Simplicity. You can corrupt this word. You can corrupt this word. This is correct English. Mm-hmm. Using instead of the term simple, simplicity, you can say this is cheap. You can say like this. I use soft gel technique. This is cheap technique. I'm not using cheap technique. The term cheap technique. I'm using the term, this is simple technique.
Yes.
I'm saying this is simple and very powerful technique.
Yes, yes.
Yeah? Yeah. Chemical synthesis for nanomaterials is simple and very powerful technique.
Yeah.
Very powerful technique. This is right approach. Term cheap is very negative term. Okay. Very negative term. It's the same term actually, to give you some parallel. In English language, we went to the Artesania's market, La Ciudadela. La Ciudadela, yeah? La Ciudadela. Englishmen are using term primitive work. Primitive. Arte primitiva. For me, it has very negative connotation.
Yeah.
It means that some peasant somewhere sitting, somewhere, you know, created this piece of work. No, I'm not accepting this term. I prefer the term taken from French language. They are using the term art naive. Mm-hmm. Naive art. Naive art coming from heart, coming from heart, many times very beautiful. You know, look at the colors, very joyful colors, very beautiful piece of craft, art naive. I will avoid using term cheap. I will say simple, but very powerful.
Yes, yes.
This is the right approach, not cheap.
Okay, okay.
Simple and very powerful. I'm not seeing any reason to be ashamed of the simple approach.
Okay.
There is no need to complicate life many times. Simple approach is the best. That's what I believe. In every aspect of life, not only in sensor technology.
Okay.
Simple. I am avoiding all this, you know, this is, let's emphasize myself properly. This is some stereotypes in thinking. Who is using this term cheap? Government bureaucrats?
No. There are some not convenient behavior of some the past researchers.
Can I say something? Mm-hmm. When I am describing my own work, my own results, using term cheap, I am putting myself down. I'm downgrading myself. When I'm saying I obtained these nice results using simple technique, which is very powerful technique, I'm lifting myself up. I'm proud of my results. That's it.
Yes.
I don't care what other people are saying. I'm sure, I'm convinced, nice morphology, yeah? I'm proud of these results. If somebody says cheap, I'm saying, don't waste my time. Go away.
Yes. Yeah. So, related to this, for example, the agencies that give us the money,
yeah,
for example, were convinced an argument that some people used to get some financial support. This technique will be permit us to produce I don't know what kind of devices because the technique is very cheap. Then this is an inconvenient combination.
It's completely wrong approach.
Yes, yes.
Completely wrong approach, completely wrong way of thinking, because again, it's nothing wrong to use simple approach. Nothing wrong. I had I tell you something. At UCLA, I will visit one of my ex-PhD student from Melbourne. He's associated professor now. He always used to say, life should be simple. Life should be simple. Simple life is a good life. It's the best life. And this devise is also important in sensor technology. Simple approach, many times, is the best approach. And I'm proud that I applied that I employed this simple approach. I would not, you know, we are dealing with different people. Sometimes they are using wrong language. You have to try to convince them that they are wrong. So probably it could be difficult for some people, that's right?
Okay.
You're welcome. So we had a very nice general discussion, but now I'm trying to go to the core of your thinking. To the core of your thinking. Why you are saying this and very rich countries, very rich. Mexico is not a poor country.
It's
not a poor country.
Yes, the country is very rich.
Country is very rich. Country is very rich. Country is very rich. It's a very rich culture. Very rich culture. Very rich history. You know.
But it's a very complex.
It's a complex situation. Of course, it's a complex situation. But tell me, please. If you look around the world nowadays, today, do you know any country around the world where the situation is very simple?
No.
I don't know. Look at the situation at your neighbor.
No. Yes.
Shut down. Shut down. Yeah? No money to pay government employees.
Yeah.
God knows, world crisis is coming again because of it. Yeah? You know, you believe that situation in Japan is simple?
Here with us.
What?
We ask for money to pay it.
Let's conclude. Let's be positive.
Yes.
If you are positive, you always will be successful. Thank you very much for your coming. And see you tomorrow at 10. Yes?
And what about the... We can use low cost instead of cheap. Low cost.
No, because I think we are a consequence
of cheap.